every day when I wake up. I can see His mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, His plans for me is to.
Well, good morning, grace and peace from God our Father. Welcome to Fresh Start. My name is Pastor Daryl Ferret. I'm excited, as always, to begin a brand new day with each and every one of you. And I'm grateful and thankful that God has allowed us to have this time together. Fresh Start is our time of focus and fellowship. And it is our time to build our faith based upon the truth that we find in the Word of God. You know, the Bible says in Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse number 23, that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is His faithfulness to you and to me. And every day that we know that we are above ground and not beneath, it is a brand new day that God has brought us into, and He's given us a fresh start, a fresh download of His grace and of His mercy. I hope that you will help me grow this community by asking others to join us every morning. Let them know, listen, if you've got 7 minutes at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, listen, join us for Fresh Start. It's going to be a blessing to you. Well, we've been working our way through 2 Kings chapter number 3, verses 16 through 18 for the last couple of days. I want to go right back to it again this morning. The Bible says, while the harpist was playing, the hand of the Lord came upon Elisha, and He spoke to Elisha and gave him some instructions. Dig ditches. Then He says these words. This is what the Lord says. You will neither see the wind nor the rain, yet this valley will be filled with water, and you and your cattle and your animals will drink. This is an easy thing in the eyes of the Lord. Now, we've been working, as I said, our way through this short passage of Scripture. And one of the other things that I want to point out in this passage of Scripture is simply this, that as we go into a brand new year, not only is God fine-tuning our discernment, not only is God helping us to know His voice and to obey Him, but one of the other things that we're discovering is that as we obey God and obey His voice, He is not just setting us up, He's setting up those that are connected to us. Can I share with you that your obedience is not just about you, it's about those that are connected to you. Remember, God told Elisha, dig ditches. And when you dig those ditches, your animals are going to drink, you are going to drink. In other words, you're going to be refreshed, and those that are connected to you and those who you are responsible for, they're going to be refreshed as well. Your and my obedience is not just about us. It's about those that God has called to our sphere of influence. And we've got to make sure that we take our obedience to the will of God and to the Word of God seriously enough that we're able to walk out the truth. Because here it is, your and my obedience is getting ready to be a blessing to someone else. There is more on the line than just you. There is more on the line than just your miracle. There is more on the line than just your turnaround that we talked about a couple of mornings ago. There is more to what's getting ready to happen than just what's going to happen for you. And so I want you to know that what you do is going to set up you and those connected to you, not just your family. Their friends are going to be blessed because of who you are and what God has allowed you to do. There are some co-workers that are getting ready to be blessed because of what God has called you to do and what God has allowed you to be able to do. So don't take your time of obedience and training and preparation as personal only. Yes, it's going to affect you, but it's not just about you. As a matter of fact, as we close out this morning, I'm going to try to put some time on the clock for you this morning. As we close out this morning, I want you to put in the chat area, it's not about me. It's not about me. Come on, put it in the chat area. It's not about me. It's not about me. There's more riding on this than just my miracle. There's more riding on this than just my breakthrough. And God's going to allow me to set up the next season of my life through my obedience. Listen, this is all the time that I have for you this morning. Trust God in this brand new day. And whatever you've got to face today, just know you faced something on yesterday. You've outlived it. God was with you yesterday, and God's going to be with you today. I will see you in the morning. Welcome to your fresh start. God bless. This is the gospel.